What's up, everyone? It's Scared Eye 7 from Scared Eye Productions, and today I'm going to do my review on the Apex 37 Diamond Drop. So the Apex 37 Diamond Drop is literally one of the best freestyle boards ever. It combines all the good things you would have in a dancer and a skateboard, and it combines it into a package that's actually the perfect style for freestyle, and it's super lightweight. And there's actually many other benefits besides that. I mean, the protection is really good, the overall shape is really good, and there is an incredible pop. And overall, it's a really good board, but as with anything in life, there are a couple of caveats, right? The screws are not very good, and the price is generally a bit high. You are getting a lot for that price, but it is a bit high, which is something to keep in mind. So in this video, I want to kind of go over those main areas. I want to go over size, I want to go over weight, I want to go over protection, I want to go over pop, and I most importantly want to go over price and my recommendations based upon all those different factors. Because as I'm going to get into later, this is a very, very specific type of board. It's a really cool board, but it's not for everyone. So that being said, let's get into it. To start off, I want to go over the size. So as I said before, the size of this board is perfect for freestyle. It's 37 inches, so it's right in that in-between spot between a pretty big dancer and a small board like the Apex 34. In my opinion, this is the perfect balance between control and having a good enough size where you feel comfortable on it, right? Because if you have a board that's too small, you can't really control it, but if you have a board that's too big, you can't really pop it. So this board kind of provides a good in-between area for that. Now, if you want to go into something like dancing, this may be a little bit too small, especially if you wanted something like cross steps. So if you want to go for dancing, I would suggest the Apex 40, because you still get the benefits of the freestyle board with the tails and the lightweight and the construction, but you get the larger size, which might be a little bit easier for doing stuff like cross steps and other dance maneuvers. So for dancing, go the bigger size, but for freestyle, 37 is not only the perfect shape, but as I'm going to get into later, it also is super lightweight and has good construction. Going on from that, let's talk about the weight. So the Apex 37 is an incredibly light board. As I can probably show you guys here, it is very, very light. Like, I can literally lift it up with one hand and it's nothing. It's totally, it's a completely light board. And as you guys might be able to see, it's also extremely thin. Most boards that are pretty lightweight offer construction that's not very good, but the Apex 37 offers a lightweight board and good construction. It's a very rare thing to see in a lot of longboards, so that's pretty cool in itself. But going on from that, because the board is really, really strong, it has this fiberglass in between the deck, it also is extremely durable. So if you're trying to like bang this around and do like a lot of tricks, you're not only going to be able to do the tricks very easily, but you're not really going to dent it very easily because it is extremely durable, which is a really cool part about the board. Let's talk about protection. So the Apex 37 has these things called nose guards, right? They're basically these things on the top of the board where they are used to kind of protect the board from things like nicks and things that would normally like mess up your tail. So they kind of protect you from that. And typically there's two of them on the Apex 37, but I actually don't have a top one. And the reason why I don't actually have a top one is because of a main problem with the protection, which is the screws. The actual deck itself is very well constructed. It's an incredibly well constructed deck that's lightweight and has, as I'm going to explain later, really good tails. The only issue is that the screws that they provide, they're not very good. And in my opinion, that is a major downside, because if you're gonna buy a board, especially if it's this expensive, you need to have good screws. Because I was just skating randomly one day and the PK nose guard screw just randomly came off, which was a tad bit annoying, honestly. And I feel like for the price, I feel like we should get better screws. But that in itself is one of two of the only downsides of the board. The way you can get around this is that if you have PK nose guards on your Apex 37, just tighten the screws every now and then. It's not that hard to really do. I do it now a lot. Now, the only thing that the protection limits is the pop. So the PK nose guard on the side of the deck, so the PK nose guard provides something that's a little bit more unique than a typical longboard tail. It makes it more flat, right? And it provides more of a skateboard type of feel. Like, this tail really feels like I'm popping it on a skateboard versus this tail, which is without the PK nose guards, which provides more of a longboard feel. It's more curved and it's generally a little bit smaller. So what that allows for is lots of two different styles. If I was going to do something like a caveman, I would really prefer to use this tail because it's just a good size and it's just a nice feel when I'm doing it. But if I'm doing something like a No Comply 180, I kind of actually prefer the longboard type of tail because it's easier to pop and control. I can't really control it that well with this one because it's just simply too big. So actually, I prefer having both tables because then I can kind of experiment with each one. But if I'm gonna be quite honest, I kind of prefer it without the PK nose guard just for doing tricks. And I think that the PK nose guard is a really good investment, but I want you guys to keep that in mind. You might want to try with one PK nose guard or one off because it gives a good balance between protection and overall comfort for tricks, right? This tail is completely protected and this one, as you can see, is quite nicked, but I honestly don't mind, right? I feel like overall, if I have one tail that's protected, it's good enough. Moving on from that, let's talk about the shape. So the shape of the board is very unique as well. It's one of the more unique stuff about the board. The board has this really cool concave. And in fact, let me go on from that and say that the board actually has this drop. Most longboards are flat all around, but the Apex 37 is different. It has this drop down profile. So what that allows for, it's different, is that it really keeps your feet locked in when you're riding. And when you're doing tricks, you're not gonna like slip out. And when you land for a trick, you're not gonna slip out. That's kind of the common theme here, right? You're not really gonna slip out. It's just gonna be completely stable. And that's one of the main advantages of the drop deck. The deck also has a lot of flex. So with that being said, if you are landing like on a really huge stair set, it's not really gonna hurt as much because the board's just gonna bounce you back up. That in itself is really good. And then the really high-end construction helps to make sure that the board is not gonna snap while you're doing this well. So that's all good. The only issue with this is that in order for you to account for not hitting the ground every single time we try a trick, you need riser pads, right? Because the drop deck lowers your center of gravity on the board. So if you don't have riser pads, your board's gonna hit the ground every single time you try a trick. And that's quite annoying. I learned that the hard way because I didn't get riser pads at first and I kept hitting the ground. But generally speaking, if you just get riser pads, you can kind of solve this entire problem. It's really not that big of a deal as long as you get riser pads. Moving on from that, let's talk about popping in tricks. So as I said before, there's two different feels that you can get from the tails, right? You can get your traditional longboard type feel, which is more curved and kind of allows for a more no-comply boneless type of feel. Or you can have kind of like a more of a skateboard tail where you're doing stuff more like cavemans and stuff of that nature. So I think, honestly, I prefer the longboard tail. I think that's better for a lot of tricks that I'm doing. But if I was gonna branch out of stuff like kickflips and ollies, I would use this tail. So I think, in my opinion, the PK nose guard falling off for me was actually a really good thing because it allowed me to experiment between both. And I think that if you guys are curious about which one you're gonna prefer, take off one of your PK nose guards and just experiment for a while. With that being said though, the tail in itself is amazing. It provides an ample pop. You can do a whole boatload of tricks. There is basically no trick that you cannot do on this board. You can go from stuff like pivots to 360 flips. I've seen almost everything on this board. And it's because of how the tail curves up that makes it different from all these other boards. So overall, either tail is amazing. Just keep that in mind, right? I'm not saying that one tail is better than the other necessarily. This is what I prefer. But either way, this board, the tails, they're amazing. And the last thing I want to talk about today is the price. So this is the major downside of this board. The deck costs $200, which is honestly an absurd amount of money for a piece of wood. Let's be honest, right? For $200, I could get 3 skate trail decks and still have money left over to buy a set of bearings. This is a lot of money. The question is it worth $200 for a piece of wood? Well, in my opinion, it is. And I'm gonna answer that very question. The reason why it's actually worth $200 is because of what you're getting that you just simply cannot get on another deck around this price point. And that's the curved tail, the feel of the longboard, the deck construction, as well as how lightweight it is. It's the perfect package. And it's really the perfect freestyle board. But with that being said, it's $200. And so therefore it's not for everyone. I think the Apex 37 is for a very specific market. I think it's for intermediate and advanced longboarders. Because if you're spending $200, you're pretty serious about longboarding, right? You wanna either start a YouTube channel, or you just wanna kinda go farther with your tricks. I think that if you're a beginner, this is not the board for you. Not because necessarily you won't be able to utilize it, but because it's just too damn expensive. You can get a cheaper board that will do you just fine. You can learn all your basics. And then you can come to this board, you can kind of experiment with it. I think before you come to the Apex, get your basis down on a cheaper board, and then you can come to this board, pay the $200, and get your money's worth out of this deck. Because if you're a beginner, you're not only gonna probably not utilize this to its full potential, but you can't just get the deck because you're a beginner. You have to get the complete, which means you're gonna be paying $320, which is ridiculous for a new deck. So overall, it's a really amazing board. It's an absolutely fantastic board. But it's just a little bit expensive for beginners. And so I think that it kind of fits more of the intermediate to advanced longboards. Anyway, with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching this video today. If you liked it, make sure you leave a like and subscribe for similar content. Also, definitely be sure to check out my Instagram because that's where I post all the major updates. And with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching once again, and I will see you in the next video.
This is a Chucky Beat production.